Hello guys, welcome back with Wilsi Banda. Today I want to talk about a free game that you can play and actually make money. Now, I'm pretty sure some of you may have heard the fuzz about NFTs games, especially Axie Infinity, a game that became so popular in many countries like Philippines, Vietnam, where people start quitting their job and doing gaming full time. Now, Axie Infinity became very popular. Unfortunately, especially in these countries, the minimum investment in order for anybody to get started is $1,000. So it became a big barrier for a lot of people who actually want to play gaming in order to make a living. So, before I jump into this free game that you can actually use it instead of Axie, and I believe it has a huge future going forward, let me explain simply why these games can make any money. Because if you don't understand how it makes the money, it's useless for us to believe it can make money. Now, the whole idea is come from NFTs. Now, to simplify this concept, because a lot of people love to be very geeky about it and go very complications, I want to make it a very simple concept. NFTs is simply a digital asset. Consider it like a piece of art that you have. When it's unique, you keep it for the long time, you can actually make money. Consider the playing cards, art pieces, whatever you would like to think of. It is something unique, and with time it increases its value because demand on that piece would go higher. In the case of Axie Infinity, for example, every character plays in the game is very unique, and there's one of them. So with time, that character gets more powerful, became better. People want to pay more money in order to get that asset. Or if you, in order to make that asset, you know, worth more money, you have to buy stuff in order to grow it. And this stuff also costs money. So I'm not going to talk about Axie. I want to jump into this specific game. So the idea is simple. Thanks to cryptocurrency, now people are actually able to make anything on the internet, whether it's silly or important, worth money. It just have to be unique, have a unique address. It cannot be replicated. This is the whole concept with a pretty, much every NFTs game. Now I'm going to jump from this into this specific game. Now, I want to highlight, because it's NFTs, it's built into cryptocurrency. Usually everything you're going to have to deal with, buy in or sell in, you will need a cryptocurrency, especially Ethereum in most games. Some other game came up with their own currency. I'm not a big fan of that. I love Ethereum, because literally the whole thing wouldn't be possible if it wasn't for the Ethereum cryptocurrency. All other cryptocurrencies, actually many of them, are built over Ethereum. Now, let's jump into the game. The game we will be talking today is called League of Kingdom. League of Kingdom is actually a game started last year. It's simple. It's something similar to Travian if you ever played it. You build your own kingdom. You make your own army. The bigger your kingdom became, the more resources you are making, the more money you can make. It is really that simple. Now, one big mistake I notice, a lot of players come in, they start the game and they just want to make money, and that's not gonna work. So you need to be very patient if you want to play this game and make real money on the long term. Now, League of Kingdom, usually if you started, again, everybody starts with level 1, you keep building up your resources, building in your army, try to stay within an ally and go from there. I'm going to explain how much money you can make out of this game and how can you actually make the money. But before we jump into there, let's focus on the game itself. Usually in order to be able to go ahead and make money, you preferably want to be in an ally. So find an alliance. Once you get started, stay with close to your allies in order to avoid getting attacked. Again, you can become literally food in this game, right? You can lose the whole thing if you are not part of a good alliance. So make sure you do this stuff when you get started. Now, when you start, you have a few days where you are under protection. All you have to do is start building your resources, make your biggest army you can make. Do not rush into using the resources. Make sure you are going up to level 25 or something before you try to cash out, because if you are having a strong army, if you have a lot of resources being produced on a long time or on a short time, you will be able to immediately cash out, and you can literally make a few hundred dollars a day playing this game doing nothing else. So it takes some time to build up, but it's very worthy. I think it would take a few months in order for somebody to be there. Or if you're willing to invest, you can actually buy a bunch of their stuff in the game in order to go ahead and, jumpstart your kingdom. I personally did not like to put money in, and they're going to keep sending you a lot of offers. The game is easy to play. It's available on iOS. It's available on Android. You can actually download it directly from there. But what you need to do in order to get started, first, you need a wallet. Because we are talking about cryptocurrencies, we are talking about Ethereum, you need to be able to, you know, put your money somewhere and all of this stuff. So my recommendation, download a wallet called MetaMask. League of Kingdoms accepts 4 wallets, I believe. MetaMask is one of the most famous one. My recommendation, go in to maybe a Chrome extension or Firefox, download it for free, make your account. Now, this is a very important step. When you do so, MetaMask will give you a special key. This key protected with your life, because this is where your money gonna be. If you lose this and something happened to your wallet, you cannot recover it. Nobody can help you there. So that key is very important. Maybe take a picture and store it somewhere, you know, important. It will be a bunch of words together. It's very important, so make sure you keep it somewhere safe. Now, once we finalize the MetaMask, you use the MetaMask to connect it with your game later. The game can be played with, you know, you can use your email to sign up, you can use Facebook, Google, so it will be very easy to install and play like any other game, which is super great. Now, the reason this game actually can make money, I highlighted earlier, it needs NFTs. So what are the NFTs in this game? The NFTs are actually the lands. So every piece of land in this game, you can buy it, but we are going to leave the buying portion now out of it. But this is what the NFT is. There's one piece of land everywhere have a unique ID. If you are, you know, develop it, if you put more money in it, it will actually increase in value and you can sell it back. Now, buying lands and selling lands is actually available on marketplaces. And it's one of the way you can make money. Also, if you own a land, you can actually build a passive income, which is super crazy about this game, because here's what you can do. I can buy land, I can develop it. What the game is doing, actually, they are making sales when people buy special packages, whatever. Based on how big your land is, how much land you own, you will earn percentage of the money that game developers have made. So it's just crazy. You can make money with the game by simply buying land and developing it. Now, it technically can become considered passive income with one trick. You need to continue playing the game, because if you don't, if you ignore your land, with time its value gonna decline and it's gonna lose its special, you know, location, and probably would still make money, but the money is not gonna be worth it. So keep that in mind if you wanna buy and sell lands, and a lot of people doing it now. My recommendation, if you want to buy land, which I honestly am very interested in buying it because I play the game, I would recommend do not buy it right now. The cheapest land as of the time I'm making this video is worth half Ethereum, which is $1,500. When they made their initial public offering, it was like $400, the same land that's right now being sold for $1,500. And this is just 6 months ago. I mean, if you buy a house, it doesn't grow in value that crazy. So definitely the lands, because there's a lot of players, it have a value, it's going up. Now, they did not sell so many, like all the lands they have. They keep issuing initial public offering for lands that are not owned from time to time. So my recommendation, just wait for the next event where they start listing lands and buy one. It's preferably buy land where you actually your alliance is there, so it's easier for you to develop it, make more resources, etc. That's my personal recommendation. It's better you have your own land or you actually using its own resources directly, and instead of, you know, your land in the middle of nowhere, nobody know if anybody is trying to get resources out of it or not. Now, as I highlighted, the more resources you are actually getting, gold, I believe stone, wood, and food, which are the 4 stuff that you can actually, you know, grow and sell later on in order to get money. You can also make sure these are, if you have a land, it has these type of resources. These resources are very important. Now, as I highlighted, I'm not concerned about this passive income portion, but I think this is going to be great because a lot of people are joining that game on a daily basis. It's one of the most popular NFTs game in 2021. So definitely if you buy a piece of land, it will grow in value. So just keep an eye when there's an initial public offering. I'm planning to make another video because I'm going to go buy a few lands for me myself because I just love the idea. I've seen people who are making passive income of like $50 or whatever just owning a land. It's ridiculous, right? I cannot make that much money. Like literally, if I'm buying the same amount of, or investing the same amount of money on real estate, it will not generate for me the same passive income. Now, I highlighted one of the way you make money is by buying a land and actually, in, you know, develop it. The other way you can actually make money is the resources. So if you have, if you grow resources really fast, and again, the more you develop yourself in the game, the faster you will be able to get these resources. So my recommendation is try to do, develop yourself, and once you are able to generate maybe 1 to 2 million resources a day, this is the time you start cashing out. All you have to do is actually go to your profile. There's an option for you where you can actually mint resources. You can send 10 million, 5 million, and 10 million of any resource, and based on the prices on the market. So I believe gold, as of the time I'm making this video, maybe around $30 or 29 something, where you actually can get rid of 1 million and get $29. So if you're making a lot of this, or you know, growing a lot of these resources, you will be able to make a lot of money really fast. I believe it can generate a couple of hundreds of dollars a day if you are one of the most developed players in the game. So just to play for now, focus on the fun side and try to grow yourself. I am invested very highly in my army, because here's what's gonna happen. If somebody attack me and they make me, you know, their farm, they destroy my army, they take my city, I will be in trouble. I will not be able to make money. So the more I'm developed, the more I'm protected, I can actually make money by attacking other people. But in the same time, even if I'm a peaceful guy, I don't want to attack, I just want to make money, it's completely fine. Having an army will scare other people from trying to take a shot on me. So League of Kingdoms by far is one of the best games out there. It's completely free to play. So yes, you can buy land if you want to invest money, but you don't have to. Now, another thing you want to keep in mind when you use MetaMask, sometimes it's going to try to give you the fastest way to sell, which can be ridiculous. 2-3 Ethereum, $6,000 to sell as a gas fee. Now, gas fee is technically just the money you need to pay using MetaMask in order to complete the transaction. It's like network fee. What you need to do, make sure you're paying the smallest amount of gas fee. So this is up on you. When you try to sell resources, try to sell 10 million, my recommendation. Don't mint 1 million or 5 million. Try to sell the maximum you can, so you can actually pay much less fee. I think if you're paying 10 million resources, maybe you can sell it for, I don't know, $100. It can be literally sold at one time, and you can pay gas fee of one time instead of selling gas fee every time. So the transaction fee will be fixed. I'm actually fixed on the moment you are making the sale, but it's not completely fixed. It will change from one day to another depending on how congested the network is. So my recommendation is just have the fun playing the game right now. Once you are really powerful, you have a lot of resources, start making, minting some of the resources. If you can buy a land, again, the lands are not here yet. Do not buy something on the marketplace for $1,500, because $1,500 for level 1 land, there's up to 7 levels. And some, I think level 7 can be sold for literally, I don't know, $10,000. It's crazy. I can actually buy level 1 land, develop it over time by just investing some of my resources. Once it became $10,000 worth of value on level 7, I can just sell it out. So this is my recommendation for today. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. If you like to see more NFTs game and the best NFTs game available right now, go ahead and smash that like button, and you will see us as soon, hopefully on We'll See Banda. And do not forget to subscribe if you are not a subscriber. Thank you guys, and stay tuned.